Yeah.
Don't drop anything.
Ooh.
You remember the film Fury?
Yeah.
Remember David Ayres, the director?
Yeah.
Right. Well, his best mate, Davis, who was that Texan millionaire,
Yeah.
He's asked about coming over to look at Kettenkrad, hence the keys.
Right.
Imagine a motorbike crossed with a mini tank. That's a German Kettenkrad. This World War II utility vehicle is every collector's dream. This could be a significant sell for me, as Davis is a successful lawyer with deep pockets. Plus, that's not all he's after. He's keen to start his own unique collection. He's interested now in acquiring Second World War military kit, specifically from the Battle of Normandy. D-Day was a huge victory, but the war was far from over. The next 3 months were spent fighting the brutal Battle of Normandy, a fight the Americans were instrumental in. 2 million Allied troops faced a fanatical German army of 850,000 who'd been ordered to hold their ground at all costs. If they lost, the German High Command knew they'd be answerable for their despicable crimes against humanity. So they commanded their ordinary troops to fight on to the bitter end. Davis is due over in just under a week, so the twins need to get cracking on the Krad. As I've told him, it's fully operational. But guess what? It ain't running, right?
Right, okay.
So can I ask you to just drop what you're doing there and jump on this? Get this wheel sorted out for me, right? Yeah. And we need to clean and buff it up. I bought this Krad a few years back for 60K and have been slowly doing it up. Fully restored, it's worth over 100 grand and possibly more to Davis, as it's from the Battle of Normandy. I need it running, because he's going to pay top dollar for this. All right, I'll leave you to it.
All right, see you later.
With Davis arriving a matter of days, the clock's ticking on getting this Kettenkrad running and saleable.
We want to sort this wheel out first.
Yeah, put the wheel on.
What's it like?
Should be all right.
Yeah.
Check the front up.
Yeah.
These are easy, just push the pin in.
Like most World War II vehicles, the Kettenkrad was designed to be easily stripped down on a battlefield.
Oh no. That's why the wheel was off. Damaged all the thread.
The thread on this pin has been dented by some heavy-handed hammering, so the nut won't twist on and secure the wheel.
All right, whack it back out.
Yeah.
I'll do. There we go.
And you can see where they damaged it.
Oh,
simple job, but just made difficult.
I now have to file down the imperfections in the thread with a thread file.
You'll have to be really careful. It depends how bad the thread is.
If Nick doesn't follow the line of the thread exactly, this pin will be useless.
That's right then. Oh, that's going. Yeah, you got it. Good.
I never doubted him, really.
There you go.
It still doesn't fit. No, I'm joking.
That's got it.
That won't come undone now.
Good.
Now that's fixed, we have to investigate why this thing won't start.
Give it a try. No, it's not even an ignition light.
Battery must be dead then.
Well, that's worse
than dead.
Dead and gone.
I think we found Bruce's electrical problem, but a missing battery is the least of our worries.
That ain't good.
No, that's not good either, no.
Gonna have to clean all this corrosion out of here.
The bluish fuzz is actually formed by the copper in the terminal clamp, reacting with the battery's acid. This terminal is so corroded, there is no way the current can get from the battery.
Not that there is one, mind you.
Right, get the kettle on then.
What, a cup of tea?
No. Clean up job on that. Put that in boiling water, that'll come off.
There was me hoping for a cuppa. Top tip, boiling water dissolves the corrosion and a smear of grease after stops it reoccurring.
You want to do it when it's really hot?
It stinks.
Yeah, it will.
There you go. Well, that's got it all off. Look at that. That's good. I'll give this to Bruce, shall I? Some acid soup.
Yeah.
That'll keep him going for a while.
That's the terminal sorted. Now we need power. Luckily, modern batteries work pretty much the same as World War II ones.
Have you got a battery?
Yeah.
Just drop it in there, then.
I trap my fingers in it, didn't I?
Positive first.
Otherwise, you get sparklers.
Yeah, firework display.
It's schoolboy stuff, but connecting the wrong terminals to this 6-volt battery will short-circuit it. And I'm pretty sure this is the only battery we have that fits the Krad.
See if that works first.
Still got no ignition light. Completely dead. Did you turn the power on?
I'll turn the power on.
What a muppet.
We have ignition.
Hey, hello.
Ready?
Yeah.
This battery may have enough charge to power the ignition lights, but nowhere near enough to turn the engine over.
Is that jump leads?
Well, do that.
So we've got one last hope, jump-starting off another vehicle's battery.
If that doesn't work, Davis will have come all the way from Texas to see a conked-out Kettenkrad.
See how we get on with this.
Believe it or not, a charged battery doesn't have to be in a running vehicle to jumpstart a flat one.
All right, try again.
Ready?
Yeah.
Yeah! Yes. Fantastic. Good. Excellent.
She's running like a dream.
Thank goodness, because Bruce would have had us for breakfast.
That's good. Brilliant. That's running good.
Now it's chugging away, the dynamo will charge the battery up, and we have one fully functional Kettenkrad.
Super. Cross that one off the list then.